Hello everyone, so here I have a M3 2023 MacBook Pro 14 inch, 8 gigs of RAM, and here I have the 2022 MacBook Air with 16 gigabyte of RAM, 13.6 inch. So basically M3, M2, which pretty much everybody is saying that there's no big difference, but I just had the debate, and maybe you have the same debate. So this one is 8 gigs of RAM, this is 16 gigs of RAM. M2, M3, better speakers, bigger screen, arguably better screen and speakers, lower quality screen speakers, which is debatable, but I mean, you know, this is what the spec says. This is thicker, this one is less thicker. If you close both, basically, the MacBook Air is going to be pretty much as the lower part of the Pro. Right here is basically, this is the MacBook Air. So the thickness is going to be exactly the same part, the lower part. So you kind of like having a little bit more thicker than the Air. And also it's a little bit smaller in terms of size. Right here. Okay, let's see. Yeah, right here. You can see it's a little bit smaller. So not a huge difference, but it is a difference if you use this. If it's portability is your main reason you're buying this computer, I guess it's kind of like important. But for me, it was portability was very important. But at the same time, I wanted the speaker and a bigger screen and a nicer screen. So I was debating what's more important. Also, 16 gigabyte RAM, 8 gigabyte RAM. M3 newer, M2 a little bit older. But I say it's not a huge difference in terms of performance. But let me tell you one thing. So basically, between these two, so none of them is going to be for a professional, right? If you're getting a pro, professional person, specifically you buying, you're going to buy the top of the line spec, right? M3 Pro at least, 16 gigabytes RAM. But Apple actually made this for people who you actually buy the MacBook Air, but they wanted the speaker and the screen of a Pro. Okay, so basically, you can buy this one with M3 processor, the same as this one, and this is going to be still cheaper, even if you go with the 16 gigabyte. So now with the M4, it came out with the MacBook Pro, which the standard version comes with 16 gigabytes, no more 8 gigabytes. So I think Apple will introduce this one, basically introduce for people that want an Air, but they were missing on the screen and the speaker. So basically they kind of like a small upgrade because it was the cheapest version. And then this year they came with M4, but they upgraded for 16 gigabytes RAM. That means that this one is going to be cheaper. And at the same time, you can buy this one because they upgraded the M2, M3 MacBook Air to 16 gigabytes as well on their website. They still have the 8 gigabytes, but the price pretty much of the brand new one is going to be for the 16 gigabytes Air. So you can buy a 16 gigabytes Air M2 for $750 on Amazon, or $899 M3 on Amazon. This one is not available for some reason, I guess, because they are selling the 16 gigabytes. On Amazon is, I think, $1,500. Or close to $1,500, so the difference would be $1,600. Okay, but the newer one is going to be 16 gigabytes and 16 gigabytes. So I'm just comparing, if you have the 23 model with 8 gigabytes, and should you upgrade for the 16 gigabytes? So because Apple came up with artificial intelligence and they're releasing it, and the MacBook are going to have their Apple intelligence as well, not only the iPhones, I think they decided to upgrade for the 16 gigabytes all their models, because they realized that everything what they're gonna have in the future presenting with Apple intelligence requires more RAM. So even if you have the silicon processor M1, M2, M3, M4, you kind of like, they decided that I think that they're going to get the 8 gigabytes of RAM, because basically the iPhone comes with 8 gigabytes, 6 gigabytes and 8 gigabytes. So basically, you know, they should upgrade their MacBook. So now they're offering all the lineup, the standard, the newest for 16 gigabytes. So before, let's go for the next step. So I opened YouTube right here, and I got, I wanted just to show you the screen size and quality, and you should be the judge if you like it or not, or which one you enjoy it more, or which one is better. So for example, let's get a movie trailer. Let's get the same movie trailer, let's say, right here.
You asked for me. Here I am. You want to help me? Is there anything you remember?
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, that is...
All right, so let's see the same one right here.
You asked for me. Here I am. You want to help me? Is there anything you remember?
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, Thaddeus Ross.
Whatever this is, Cap, be careful. Whatever this is, Cap, be careful.
What do we know? We know.
There were 5 shooters. This was a coordinated terrorist attack. 5 shooters. This was a coordinated terrorist attack, sir.
I was a wartime general. Now I'm a wartime president.
Now, actually, I'm gonna turn on both.
Your inner circle's been compromised. Let me fix.
Without sound, so you can check both. So this is the lightning inside, and you can see both at the same time. Okay, let's. Okay, let me put exactly on the same. Okay, 103. Right here. Okay, now you can see if there's any difference at all in the image quality or image how you can see in a regular room. And if the bigger screen is going to make a difference or not. You can see that this, it's a little bit shorter, so you're going to have a little bit more screen. Okay, so you can see that this too, basically. So you can have a little bit more real estate in this one, but when you're watching side by side, I mean, it's very hard to say there's any difference at all. Let's do another test. Let's make the full brightness on both. This full brightness on both. Okay, let's put it in 1080p. 1080p. Let's see if I can get it in enhanced bit rate. I don't know if it's gonna load because you need like fast internet for that one. So it's not gonna load, I guess. Let's get in regular HD. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go for a different one. Okay, let's go for okay, so I don't know if you can see, both are actually in 60 frames. I set up this one in 60 frames, but if you want you can set it up in you go to display and you can set it up in promotion. So right now it's in promotion. I don't know if you can see this on camera or not. I don't think it's visible in the camera. Okay, so let's see, let's put another trailer. Let's put ballerina. Ballerina. Both HD. Let me get this one HD both. Okay. Okay, now you can see the difference basically. If you can see any difference at all. I mean, I would say that if you look side by side, you would say that the Pro would be a little bit better. Maybe you would see the difference in real life a little bit if you put them close by side by side, but would be kind of like arguably the same. If you would just pick one over the other one to watch movies, I don't think you would see a big difference. I mean, of course, this one is going to be bigger screen, maybe nicer experience, but if you just take this one and you know watch the movie separate, it would be the same experience as taking this one and watching the movie separate. So, you know, this one is going to be for sure better sound than this one, but not in such a way that you wouldn't hear nothing from this. You're still going to hear the movie and everything, maybe not as loud as here. So if, I guess in terms of loudness, this one, you know, is going to be better. In terms of portability, this one is going to be better, the Air. So in terms of screen quality and you know, and they're not going to be a huge difference between them. And I would say like this, it's very easy to pick, take the Air if you care about portability, 16 gigabytes, M2, M3, whatever, it doesn't matter because you're getting, you know, pretty much long term, and get this one. But actually, if you buy them brand new, you're going to get the 16 gigabytes as well, but you're basically paying a lot for the Pro just to get a bigger, nicer screen and a nicer speaker. Because everything else inside is going to be pretty much the same. The same, if you're getting the Air with M3, you're going to have the same M3, the same 16 gigabytes of RAM, basically everything the same. So you're paying $1,600 for this one, or I think $1,500, and this one you're paying $900. So the difference between them is $600. So $600, it's worth the speaker and the screen. For me personally, not really. Maybe if you buy this one, maybe if you find on Amazon for $1,300, there will be $400 difference, but still $400 difference is kind of a huge difference. You're kind of getting a thicker model. And also, you know, the ports. So I don't know. I mean, if you don't have a camera where you connect other devices like external screen, it doesn't really matter. Honestly, because you have here everything what you need, You know, you have a Type-C, two Thunderbolts, and you have the regular magnetic charger, which is the same as this one. This one's going to be faster. This is going to be a little bit slower. But, you know, you want to buy, like, pay $400, $600 difference just to go to get a little bit faster. So, yeah, I guess, you know, this is the main dilemma for a lot of people, I guess. The Apple is making it a little bit complicated and more options, and they're getting pretty much everybody to buy a MacBook. And it doesn't matter who you are. You can be cheap ass. There is a laptop for you. If you are you want to get the best and the greatest, they have a laptop for you. If you want to get a professional one, they have the Pro. If you want a portable one, they have the Air. If you are a student, they have the Air. If you are making a present, they have the option for you. They have Pro models, regular models, smaller, bigger, different colors. So, you know, I guess that Apple is kind of professional doing the business. So they got us, everybody, in the same boat to buy an Apple product. Thank you for watching this video.